The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
As Jesus passed by, he saw a man blind from birth. His disciples asked him, Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered,
Neither he nor his parents sinned. It is so that the works of God might be made visible through him. We have to do the works of the one who sent me while it's day. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world.
When he had said this, he spat on the ground and made clay with the saliva and smeared the clay on his eyes and said to him,
Go wash in the pool of Siloam,
which means sent. So he went and washed and came back able to see. His neighbors and those who had seen him earlier as a beggar said, Isn't this the one who used to sit and beg? Some said, It is. But others said, No, he just looks like him. He said,
I am.
So they said to him, How were your eyes open? He replied,
The man called Jesus made clay and anointed my eyes and told me, Go to Siloam and wash. So I went there and washed and was able to see.
And he said to him, Where is he? He said,
I don't know.
Look at me now, that can't be denied.
life as a human being in this planet. I've seen so many people in different ranks, so to speak, in their spiritual journey. Some have not even started making the first step. And in the diversity of where we are in our own faith journey, I've come to believe that faith indeed is truly a gift. I mean, we are experiencing the same world, the same universe. We are experiencing basically the same realities of living, including our happiness, our blessings, but also our trials, our tribulations, our pains and suffering, our sorrows, our fears. We are basically experiencing the same realities in our lives, but we experience them in different contexts. But the things that we experience are pretty much similar with each other. And that makes us united with each other, but we are reacting differently to these experiences. Think about how all of us seeing the same sun at different times as the sun, as we go around the sun, and as the planet turns around the sun or in the sun. But people also react differently to the sun, in the same way that the plants and the flowers and the trees don't grow the same way, that don't bloom the same way, and they some bloom more, some others don't. And I found indeed that it always begins with a gift. Faith begins with a gift. But when you get the faith, you know the difference. You know the difference when you get the gift of faith, because faith allows you to see. The story of the man born blind is a beautiful parable, metaphor, of how God takes the initiative to send the gift of faith as Jesus encounters this blind man. Man born blind, never saw the beauty of the planet, of the earth, of the world. And I think here we see that it is Jesus that makes the word possible. He begins by putting the clay. There's an encounter in the beginning where Jesus was passed by and saw a man born blind. So it's Jesus that passed by, and it's the disciples that said to him, Rabbi, ask the question, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he's blind? And the story proceeds from there. It is also interesting that there are people that kind of referred Jesus to the blind man, or referred the blind man to Jesus. And in this case, it makes sense in the story of our spiritual journeys. Sometimes, and most of the time, we actually encounter our faith with and through other people. It could be a friend. It could be a family member. It could be a priest. It could be your parents when they decided to baptize you as a kid and continue to teach you about that faith as you grew older and came to understand really the depth of our faith. It could be all kinds of different ways, but most of the time, our faith is connected to a reference point. Gabriel Marcel, one of my favorite philosophers, said that in everything around us, in everything about the universe, there is always a primary reflection and a secondary reflection. The primary reflection is primarily all about the things that we see apparently around us. You know, what is visible to us, what is apparent. And he said that there's always another reflection deeper than the first reflection, and that is the spiritual meaning or the mystery that is hidden behind the things that we see or experience. And he says that the goal is not only to stay in the primary reflection, but to dig deep into the mystery of the secondary reflection. The secondary reflection is very much about the spirit. Another thing that comes to mind to me today is the story of the little prince. There is a rose, and there is a claim that the rose is the only one rose in the universe. And then later on, as the prince gets to Earth and sees a beautiful rose garden, he thought that the rose friend of his in his own planet is actually lied about being the only one unique rose in the world. There's a lot of roses! And the friend fox said to the prince, it is the time that you spend with your rose that makes your rose unique. That is secondary reflection. Yes, there are many other roses, but there's no one other rose and the one that she spent time with. So now the prince sees the rose differently. Faith is the same as the secondary reflection. It is the same as seeing the rose in its uniqueness. Faith is a way of making us see. Faith is a way of seeing. We may all see the same thing. We all see the same bread on the table and the same bread is lifted up. Some people will see the bread and they say, that's bread. The people of faith see it and say, that's Jesus. We proclaim words here at church. We have books and books and books to derive sacred, inspired scriptures. When we hear it, we say, oh, that's a nice story. Oh, this is a nice little, you know, encouraging word. We can put it on our wall and write it down. But it's different when you're listening with the ears of faith. What you're hearing is not just a story. What you're hearing is inspired words of God. So there is a big difference in the way we encounter the world when we have faith. And this faith may not be something that other people necessarily like or appreciate. Because of our faith, it is so easy for us to become unliked or hated, unfriended by some people around us. And just like in the story of the man born blind, as he proclaims that he was able to see because of a man named Jesus, there are those oppositionists that will tell him, oh, who is that? You know, they're questioning why. This cannot be the work of God. This must be the work of some weird reality out there. Maybe the work of evil or whatever it is. Maybe the work of sin. Why did you, how did you get to see? And they couldn't understand what's going on. The moment you see through the eyes of faith, you are changed from deep within you, that you become different from the others that don't see the same way. And you will always be misunderstood because you're seeing things differently in the eyes of faith. Ultimately, I think, in this encounter with Jesus and the blind man, what we find is Jesus not only healing the man's sight, but actually it is Jesus allowing a personal encounter between him and the blind man. At this moment, the encounter is so profound that the man who was made to see is now open, has opened his heart and says, can you tell me who he is that I may follow him? So now it's no longer just the faith that allows him to see everything, but it's also the faith that allows him to follow the Lord, to follow God, to attach one's life, our life, to the one that gave us the faith. So, I mean, today as we come to the second scrutiny of our RCIA catechumens, actually, we are very excited because what happens today, what happens in these days, as you receive this gift of baptism, is that you are empowered by the Lord to be able to peek through that mystery, to be able to see deeper, and to be able to understand more profoundly that not the most important realities about our lives are those that we are not able to see with our naked eyes, but we are able to see with the eyes of faith. And I am very, very excited together with our community about the way the Lord will reveal himself to you as you receive the gift of faith and this baptism. The Lord already invites you in many ways now to be able to open your eyes and see this with the eyes of faith. And when you receive the sacrament, the Spirit of the Lord will empower you to be able to remain, keep your eyes wide open. So may the gift of faith continue to inspire us to be able to see through the things that we see now. One final comment is, I've been praying for all of us to be able to see through what God is doing to us here in Kankakee. In the listening sessions, I've received a lot of responses. The first question in the first question in the listening sessions was, what is God doing? What is God asking us to do? here in Kankakee during this time of transition. One of the most interesting answers that was given was, I don't think it's God who's asking us, I think it's the bishop. Yes, primary reflection, the bishop is asking us. But if we're not able to move beyond what the bishop has asked us, just to be able to see the spiritual reality that's happening here in Kankakee, it must only be through the eyes of faith that we are shut with our cynicism, that we are able to see truly what God is doing to us here in Kankakee. Until then, I don't think we will be able to understand what's happening around us. We will always be lost, and we will never be found. I hope it doesn't happen like that forever. Amen.